The time for estate planning is now. For estate planning, the environment in which you execute your plan is just as critical as having a plan. And today is the perfect environment for high net worth individuals and families to maximize flexibility, minimize taxation, and execute the plan that meets their goals and objectives. Thanks to the Tax Cut and Jobs Act of 2017, today's estate tax exclusion is $11.7 million per taxpayer, or $23.4 million per couple. But at the end of 2025, the exclusion amount is set to revert back to an inflation-adjusted $5.49 million, which is what it was in 2017, which is why it is critical to take advantage of today's higher exclusion amounts. Also, any planning you do now should hold up because the IRS has been reluctant to claw back money from estates that took advantage of prevailing tax laws. When transferring assets from an estate, we utilize two main methods, gifting and selling. We recommend gifting for estates under the exclusion amount, but for larger estates or for clients who require more flexibility, selling offers additional opportunities. Ultimately, our aim is to lock in the increased gifting allowances before they expire while also taking advantage of today's historically low interest rates. These rates offer several excellent ways to minimize the estate tax. For example, we might consider gifting a highly appreciating asset like a business to a family member through what's known as a grantor-retained annuity trust, or GRAT. Once the asset is inside the GRAT, the grantor receives payments from the trust for a number of years. The interest rate on these payments is based on the 75-20 rate set by the IRS, which as of June 2021 was just 1.2%. At the end of the term, any assets that remain in the trust pass to the beneficiary. If the grantor outlives the trust, any amount within the grant is excluded from the estate. Another strategy is valuation discounts, which can artificially reduce the value of an asset for transfer purposes. Assume a couple owns real estate that is worth $100 million. Gifting it outright would subject the vast majority of the asset to estate and gift tax. Instead, we could use a family limited partnership to divide the asset into 10 general partner voting shares and 90 limited partner non-voting shares. While the underlying asset is worth the same, the non-voting shares don't have the same value because they lack marketability and control. For argument's sake, let's assume those shares have a 30% discount. So 90% of the real estate can be transferred for a value of $73 million, not $90 million. At the current 40% federal estate tax rate, you save $6.8 million in federal transfer taxes while still retaining control of the assets and transferring the future value to the next generation. Naturally, the political landscape is constantly shifting and it's hard to know what changes to the estate tax the future will bring. That's why we recommend taking advantage of the high estate tax exclusion amounts and low interest rates while you can. The time to start learning how you, your heirs, and your legacy can benefit from a well-crafted estate plan is now.